Hi guys, how are you doing? So guys, my name is Kewal Kishan. I'm a business automation expert. Guys, in today's video, we're going to learn on how to collect your data using Google Forms and how it can automatically transfer into Google Sheets. Now guys, before starting the video, I would like you to like the channel, subscribe the channel and share it with your colleagues as well. And you know, hit the bell icon as well so that when a new video comes up, you should get to know it at once. Okay, so let's learn on how to create a Google form to collect the data. So guys, jaise aap dekh sakte hain, you can see that I have opened the Google right now, google.com, and there is a tab which says all the applications mentioned. So when you go to this site, it says the Google form, right? So aap isko click karenge and you open the Google form tab. Now you guys can see here that there's an option called start a new form. Okay, it's a blank form, and let's create a blank form and let's learn and actually what all functionality do we have in Google form to collect the data very easily. Now here you can see that I have created a blank form, and first of all what you would need to do is that give this form a title. So imagine we are creating this form to take the order from the client. Okay, so order form as an example. Here you can write the description. Now the first thing which you need to take, obviously, as a data set, as a question, is the name of the customer. So here you can see that I have written the name here. At this side, it says the type of the question. Okay, so you can see it's a short answer, paragraph, multiple choice, checkbox, drop down, and many other type of questions. Now because Google form is that particular tool of GSuite which can help you to create these kind of forms and can help you to collect the data from anywhere through any device, even through mobile and tablet. Okay, so here let's start with defining the first variable called name. Now I shall give it the type of the question as an answer, short answer. Okay, the next type of question which we need to create, firstly I need to go to this section which says add question. So when I click on add question, it comes up with another blank question. Yahan pe main likh sakta hun, email ID. Right, now email ID, it automatically gets converted to short answer. It says that enable email collection setting. So isme kya hota hai, when you enable it, out of all the questions, the first question will be the email ID of the user. If you don't enable it, the user can fill it up while filling up the form and on the way. Okay, now the third question which you can add here, I need to go back to this section again, and I can click here and I can add the third question. Here I can ask person to write about the mobile number so that we can reach out to the person. Now you can see guys, when I write the mobile number, it says the response validation has been added, and it automatically has added that it should be number. Okay, and instead of this, we could have had text, length, and other data validation rules. So mobile number, jaise maine enter kiya, it shows that it should be number only, right? Now before going further guys, aap dekh sakte ho, chahe wo name ka question tha, ya wo email ID tha, ya fir mobile number tha. At the right bottom, there's an option called required in all of the three. Okay, when I click on the required, it means ki wo particular question ko answer karna mandatory hai. The user cannot skip to answer that particular question. Now in the email ID as well, you can see that here we have made it required, we have made it mandatory for the user to fill up the email ID, and same case goes with the name as well, right? So we have added three things: name, email ID, and phone number. Let me add a fourth question called products. Imagine we have five products and we want the user to select one of the product. Second, the next question we shall have is the quantity. What is the quantity of the product which we want to add? Okay, so here we'll click, and let me just take it down. You can drag the question as well. We'll drag it to the last question, right? Let me take the mobile number up. Yep. Now here I can write, choose the product, right? In the product, I have multiple type of options which says multiple choice, checkbox, drop down. Okay, so let me go ahead with multiple choice, and here I can write product A. And if I want to add multiple products, I can write product B and then product C and many more. Product D, right? Now it is again a mandatory question because I want user to fill the product which he or she wants to select. Right? Now I can write required here. Now again the next question we want to add is the number of quantity of that particular product. So how much quantity is required as a sample? Here I can ask for the short answer. Automatically we will detect it that we are expecting a number, a quantity. So it says that a number, and I can add some validation here as well. So I'm just making it mandatory as well. So guys, you can see that a basic Google form is now ready. Now let's firstly see on how does it look like when we open it in mobile or tablet or any other platform. So guys, you can see at the top right, there's an option called preview. So when I click on preview, it opens the Google form. And guys, you can see it opens like this. Name, email, mobile, choose the product, how much quantity is required. So the left tab is where we are editing it. And the right tab is where we are. We can see the product form live. Further, before going further, you can see that this particular section, actually I can, I can open the settings tab as well, and I can see few settings which I can make it mandatory for us to collect the email address. I can limit one response to one person, and for that they need to sign in from the Gmail before filling it up. So there are multiple areas. I can customize even the theme. So when I click on the theme, I can actually choose an image. So for example, if I choose this particular image, okay, so this image comes as a background in our entire Google form. Right now if I again preview it, a background photo is coming up in the form, right? Easily customizable. Guys, you can add the video as well in the Google form. In one of my videos you can search on how to add a video in the Google form. Okay, now here let me just fill the form. Okay, imagine I'm interested in product B and I want 5 of these products, right? So when I submit it, the data gets submitted, and when I go to this particular tab where I was creating the form, at the right side you can see a tab called responses. Now when I fill that Google form, here you can see that automatically a response has come up which shows some basic data and analysis as well. Guys, let me add one more data. One more form, and then let's see what kind of data are we collecting away. Okay, so Rahul, just filling up a dummy database. Now Rahul wants product A and he wants 4 quantity. Data is again submitted, guys, and you can see that automatically it detects 2 responses. The first is Kewal, second is Rahul, and the mobile number. And you can see a pie chart coming here, beautiful pie chart, which says that 50% of the data is product D and the 50% is product A. So it is basically 2 responses that we got. 50% people choose product B and 50% people choose product A. Here you can see the quantity required by these people. Now you can see that this particular data is coming in a list. Now imagine if you want this data to be in the Google sheet. Will that be great to have? Yes. So at the right side, you can see this particular icon called create a spreadsheet. So when I click on this, it gives me 2 options, either to create a new spreadsheet or select an existing spreadsheet. So if I click on the new, I can rename it. I can say order data. Okay. Let me create it, guys. So guys, this is the beauty of Google Forms, that you can easily create a Google form. And guys, you can see right now here that whatever data we had filled in the Google form, jo humne fill kiya the Google form mein, automatically wo data aapke samne yahan pe aa chuka hai. So this is the beauty of Google form. Let me just add one more data and let me show you again. So again adding a new form. So Amit, maybe this time, let's see real time कि वो कैसे डेटा वहाँ पे आ रहा है. This time product C. Let me just click 5. Oh yeah, proxy selected and let me submit it. So when I submit this, oh, what do you think? The data is in the Google Sheet, yes or no? Yes guys, the data automatically has come up into the Google Sheet. So guys, this is the beauty of Google Forms. So in this tutorial, as you got to know on how to actually collect the data on Google Forms, guys, stay updated because we are coming up with so amazing videos of Google Forms and Google Sheets. It will make you data ready, it will make you process ready. What I want you to do is quickly subscribe the channel, like the video and comment on the comment section of what kind of other kind of technology topics you want me to cover in the GSuite platform. Keep sharing, keep learning, keep automating. Thank you so much.